really care about the BM. I think I was I had long hair. I played heavy metal in a little guitar and heavy metal band, and that was what I was into. And then my friends got a drum corps, and I started taking private lessons with a trumpet teacher who actually, you know, was motivating and got me to Maynard Ferguson and a lot of those other players. And that's when I started getting, you know, a little bit better, you know, at playing, getting more into it. So, and then took off from there, got into some groups. Went out to California for a while, played and toured with a group out there. And then that kind of led into the shop thing too, because I used to complain to my roommates about how the stores didn't really have anything of good selection. They didn't carry any good instruments, and it was just kind of like they would only sell you the house wine. Didn't really have many other options. It was whatever was cheapest for them to carry with the highest profit margin. So that was always in the back of my mind. And we goofed about it when we lived out west. And then when I started learning how to repair and realized that there was a lot of need for it, because as I was working on stuff for my own purposes back in the basement of the music building where I started, you know, a lot of people just started coming in and asking me, hey, can you fix this? This is dented, this is broken, and I need a weld for this. And hey, do you sell valve oil? And no. And then one of my friends at one point had said, do you clean horns? And I was like, no, like, I'm just back here for my own purposes, you know. And he's like, you know, if you cleaned horns, even if you just scrubbed them out with soap and water, he says, you could make some money, you know, just $20 a pop maybe, because the dorms don't have a big enough sink for you to leave your horn in, and most of the bathrooms are community bathrooms. So I started scrubbing them out, and I started making money. And then that was a little motivating, you know, to start doing that stuff. And I think I put $300 in my first set of tools. I bought a couple mandrels and a dent roller. And I made $3,000 the first year, I think $10,000 the next year. And been doing better and better every year since then. 10 years this month I've been in business, so.